In today's gospel, we see this steward acting in a very dishonest way. That's not what the Lord wants him to do. And obviously, that's not what the Lord wants us to follow, to be dishonest. He wants us to be honest and to have an integrity of life. What he wants us to know is that if we can think and plan and work hard on the things of this world, we can do the same for the world that is to come, which is even more important. If we can spend nights planning and working hard, investigating, we can also work hard for the things that belong to the Lord, for the things that belong to heaven, and to be dedicated and committed to that. If we can be committed and dedicated to the things of the world that are today and might not be tomorrow, imagine what we can do for the things that are eternal. So that's what the Lord presents this steward as an example to us, not because he is dishonest, but because he's thinking, he's planning. He wants us to do the same for the things that are from above, from heaven. We have been talking, my brothers and sisters, about how the Lord wants us to be closer to him. The Lord is the master. He is the only one. Even though in the world, the devil presents himself as the master and prince of this world, we know that the true one is our Lord Jesus Christ. And we have been talking lately in these Sundays of the summer how the devil is trying to take us away from the Lord, and he is presenting different ways for us to be confused and to be away from the Lord. We talk about how he had different strategies and different attacks toward us. The first one that we talk about was temptations. Temptation is the more common attack from the devil. And it is a temptation, it is something that comes to everyone, all of us, you and I, suffer these attacks from the devil, temptations. And a temptation, we know, is an unhealthy curiosity. It is a way for the devil to take us away from Christ. But there is a stronger attack coming from the devil, and that is infestation. And we talk about how a house, a place, an object can be infested. And it is a way for the devil, since he is not everywhere. The devil uses something that has been dedicated to him or has been in contact with him to have an infestation and from there work on the lives of people. And then there is also a stronger attack, which is vexation. The vexation is when the devil attacks the people around the person that he wants to be condemned and destroys his family, destroy his job, his material possessions, and even his health. And we saw how a clear example of vexation is found in the book of Job, where the just Job lost everything, and he was attacked without vexation from the devil. Remember how all these attacks, including the temptation, come from the devil, not from God. God doesn't come against us with temptations or all these evil things. God is the source of everything that is beautiful and holy and right and just and beautiful. The opposite comes from the source that is opposite to him, the devil. But from the Lord comes only what is sacred. And today I would like also to mention another terrible attack from the devil, which is obsession. So he can also work in the mind of the person. And through an obsession, the devil wants the person to either kill himself or to kill someone. And it comes with an obsession. It becomes a thought in the mind of the person that is so dangerous. The devil is saying to the person in his mind, you are worth nothing. Therefore, kill yourself or kill someone else. It's a terrible attack from the devil because he wants us to be blind from who we really are. We are images. We were created in the image and likeness of God. We belong to the Lord. We were created to be creatures of the light and of the day, not of darkness and the night and death. We were created to be with the Lord forever. That's why, and the Lord has given us this beautiful gift of life. Life is beautiful. And life is used to honor and worship our Lord and to love and serve one another and to enjoy God's creation, not to do the opposite to it, not to destroy it, including our own lives or the lives of others. So this attack of obsession is terrible, and it could begin sometimes through terrible thing that can happen to a person of depression. And the person, instead of putting everything in God's hands, starts cursing the Lord and therefore closing his heart to the graces of the Lord and opens this heart to the activity of the devil. An obsession is a terrible attack from the devil. If you know anyone, or if any one of us is suffering from these evil thoughts of killing himself or killing someone, seek help. Come to confession. Talk to a priest. Talk to someone that you know that can guide you. Because we are really God's creatures. Jesus died for us on the cross. Imagine how precious we are, that even the Lord who is God himself, our master, died for us as a criminal on the cross to show us how important we are to him, to show us how he wants us to be with him forever. So it is really against God's plan to kill ourselves or to kill someone else. Obsession, these suicidal thoughts are coming not from the Lord, but from the devil. And it is a terrible attack that with the graces of the Lord, we can overcome. May the Lord help us to guide our lives toward Christ and to help someone who is having these attacks from the devil. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.